extremely strong crew.
There is the start list. Romania, Czech Republic, Australia looking strong, Hungary, Slovakia, Germany, Russia and Denmark. Denmark have been a little bit disappointing. They are the reigning European champions. Romania then try and Niagu, Tony Iometicu, Stefan Vasili and Petrus Gavrila. Silver medalists in Zagreb in June in the European Championships. They go in lane one. The Czech Republic. Havel, Trefi, Dostal and Sterba. In Australia, Tate Smith, Dave Smith, no relation, Murray Stewart and Jacob Clear, quickest in the semi-finals. The world silver medalist last year to Hungary, and here are the Hungarian crew. The A final, straight to the final to settle the medals in the men's K4. Germany, as ever in this event, very, very strong. Silver medalists in Sydney and Athens, and Blöckel and Hoff were both part of the World Championship winning K4 last year. Russia, bronze medalists at the World Championships in Szeged in Hungary a year ago. And Denmark, as mentioned, the reigning European champions, having won in Zagreb in June, but slightly disappointing in qualifying. They go in lane 8, and it'll have to be a strong performance from then to get amongst the medals. Again, look out for Germany, look out for Slovakia. Silver medalist in Beijing 4 years ago, they go in 5. Hungary as well, and a sneaking feeling, perhaps, just for Australia. They're quickest in the semi-finals. Sometimes that's not the truest guide, because you can get a quick semi-final just because of conditions. But Australia were looking fairly strong. So the final of the men's K4 1,000 metres. At a pace these quartets set. Romania in lane 1, Czech Republic in 2, Australia in 3, Hungary in 4, with Evgeny Zoltan Kamara, Slovakia in 5, Germany in 6,
lane
Russia
8 forward.
In 7. And Denmark, who have just been called forward a little bit ready. More, started into the bucket.
Set.
Ready.
Stop,
no,
stop,
no.
Stop. All
first
box.
Start, and who was it up there? It might have been Australia, Hungary. Lane 3 or 4. You might be wondering how you can get full starts when you've got the start buckets which drop, but if you get a nudge up, you can get
all
a little bit of a
box
jump,
to the start line.
Yeah, if they get their timing exactly on, spot on, they really can just get a little fraction ahead. But at the same time, it is a risky game to play, because if you get it wrong at the same time, you either get a false start like this, or and you have to be recalled back, which takes a fair amount of time with these long crafts. They have to go all the way around.
Now a little bit of how do you do as they pass each other on the way around in various directions back to the start, so it's a bit time consuming. Here's the
all
start.
Boats come to the start line.
Might have been Hungary, might have been Australia. Didn't look to be utterly convincing. Australia certainly just out quickest, but even Romania up at the top of the picture. Very, very close. But if you get a warning, it doesn't matter. You're not going to be disqualified. I think you can carry on. False start given to Hungary, as we thought. Zoltan Kamara at the front of the boat. He made his Olympic debut back in 1996, a three-time gold medalist. He qualified directly for the final, looking very, very good. Avoided the semi-final by winning the initial heat. So the wheel round will tell you a bit more about their crews. Slovakia, you mentioned silver medalists in Beijing. The Slovakian team actually had a last moment change when the brothers, the Riesdorfer brothers, were replaced by Peter Geller and Martin Jankovic, a very strong pair themselves, but didn't go down well with the Riesdorfer brothers. And all sorts of allegations, but they look very good in qualification.
Gentlemen, please, no delay. We are on live TV broadcast. Come to the start line.
What were they being asked to do there? Not to do, because they were live TV. No swearing?
No delaying, they
delaying.
Said. Yeah, yeah. Straight to the start line. No,
no
time
swearing as well, I'm sure. That's utterly unacceptable. No delaying. This does take a long time to reset again, I suppose. That's why they're... I think the fact that they're on live television is the last thing in their minds, though. They just want to get the best start. So again, it is time consuming to wheel around.
All boats to the start line, so please.
Be interesting now to see how quickly the Hungarians get away, because if they are to false start again, that will be them out of the competition. So they won't be looking to push that line twice.
Yes, it's not an immediate disqualification as it is in athletics now. It's not a one false start in the air. You do get one chance, and then you pay the price if you do it a second time.
Lane so three,
Romania,
Australia, come to the start line, please.
Slovakia, Germany, the Russian Federation.
All bots to the start line.
Lane seven, and Denmark in eight, the final of the men's K4 1,000 metres. Hungarians had a great deal of success yesterday, and a couple of fans there among the crowd.
Lane one, keep moving forward.
Favorites here. Zoltan Kamara, David Toth, Tamas Kulifai, and Daniel Kalman.
You have a warning.
And just being made clear that they have.
Lane forward.
I have to just make sure that falls out again. There we go, it's all safe, it's all frantic fury now from these quartets as they set off at a vicious pace, and then again they drop down into that rhythm. But who gets out quicker here? Romania, Czech Republic, Australia, Hungary, Slovakia, Germany, Russia and Denmark, and taking out quickest at the moment Australia in lane three, looking strong through the first 100.
They certainly jumped their way out of the bucket. I thought Denmark went with them, but it seems they've already slipped back down the field. Their stroke rate now up around 140 before they settle into the middle part of this race.
Well, Hungary, the silver medalists in the World Championships in Hungary last year, they take it out through the first quarter just in front of the Hungarians themselves, with Slovakia in third and Germany in fourth. They were the favourites, these four, coming into the race, and so far living up to it over the first quarter of the race.
Timing is crucial in these boats. The front man really sets the pace, sets the rhythm. The second man sits there trying to make sure the connection is good through to the powerhouses in the back two seats.
So at the moment, Slovakia and Germany, Hungary also sitting there alongside Australia. Australia still leading them out. Who will have the strength in the second half of the race, though? It is Australia out there at the moment. Hungary just to their right. Then Slovakia in lane five. And Germany sitting back a little bit at the moment. Gross and Brooklyn, Wieskut and Max Hoff will have to make a bit of a push, because they're trailing as they come through the halfway mark. It's still Australia from Hungary, Slovakia, Denmark going well in lane eight. We wondered about them in the qualifying, in the heats. They didn't look too good, but looking stronger now in the final. But it's still these three, Australia, Hungary, Slovakia, in that order as they come up into the final quarter of the race. Australia took it out quickly. Tate Smith and Dave Smith, Murray Stewart and Jacob Clear, and beginning to open up a bit of a gap now.
With every stroke they're still pumping away and moving an inch further forward on the rest of the field. There we see all four men working completely in unison together, driving that boat smoothly through the water.
We wonder if they might fade. At the moment looking strong. Slovakia though, they're beginning to creep back a little bit. Hungary too, staying with Australia. It's all about holding on in the final 250 now. For Australia, for Tate Smith, for Dave Smith, for Murray Stewart and Jacob Clear, they're quickest in the semi-finals. Will they be quickest? Will they be gold medalists here in the final? Still holding on, half a length clear now, with Hungary and Slovakia tied together. Second and third, Slovakia just with the edge at the moment. Also coming up well with Czech Republic in lane two, but still out in front into the final 150 metres. It is Australia. They're not going to be caught now. The gold medal surely coming for Australia. It's about silver and bronze. And a strong finish from the Czech Republic just inside Australia. It's Slovakia and Germany also doing up the battle for the minor medals. Australia get the gold. Hungary look to have the silver. And I think coming through for bronze were the Czech Republic. But a fine race, and a race won by Australia. Gold for the men in gold. Australia have it. Tate Smith at the front, celebrating loudest of all. Dave Smith behind Murray Stewart and Jacob Clear, winners of the men's K4 1,000 metres. A great race.
Murray Stewart there in the third seat, almost doesn't look like he can quite believe what's happened. But what a fantastic race. They let it out hard. They jumped out of that start bucket and they just controlled that race. Every time a little push came from the Hungarians or from the Slovaks, they just edged their nose ahead again, putting in another little burst. They certainly dominated that race.
That is the Blues' way to win it. Going out from the front and hanging on. And Hungary will celebrate their medal as well. And Denmark faded a little bit in lane 8, but are connecting strongly with the Czech Republic in lane 2. They knew they had a stronger second half. Oh, steady. It's Dave Smith almost falling into the celebrations. It has happened before, but it was close at the end. Hungary just coming through, just ahead of the Czech Republic to take silver. Czech Republic runs, and Germany in fourth place. Nothing for the fancied German crew. Well, Australian-like conditions here at Eton Dorney this morning. It is very warm, very still as well, and there, that's what it means to win an Olympic gold medal.
And these boats of four men, is so important to keep that timing exactly together, which is what was so well executed. Tate Smith here in the front of the Australian boat, really setting a great rhythm, a great pace for the rest to follow.
Tate and Dave Smith again, not brothers, and Jacob Clear and Murray Stewart from the Manly Warringah Kayak Club, and Dave Smith from Illawarra in New South Wales. The Australian commentators are not a million miles away from us, and they're very, very happy indeed in Wynand. Australia gold medalists ahead of Hungary and the Czech Republic, but Australia winners of the men's K4 1000 metres.